Thanks a lot, Shobha, for joining us. And how significant is this victory for you? Because you had asked for, you had fought this case as advocate on record. And what were the key arguments that you had placed in front of the court?
See, we have requested for exemplary compensation for the reason because what High Court has granted and the trial court, conviction was not done to the police officials by the trial court. High Court has granted some 5,000 for Section 201 in default and 15,000 for Section 218 in default. And that was a fine only. And this is pittance. So the courts have not considered that compensation aspect for all that trauma she has undergone and the way she has been wronged not only by the private players, those private accused, but for the systematic non-compliance, systematic deliberate failure by the police official. It was not only failure, saying failure is the wrong term. They have acted, enacted in a deliberate manner to ensure that the victim is suffering, victim is not getting justice, and the accused are letting go scot-free. So the key arguments were, which we have informed the court, and court was very conscious the moment I informed about the nomadic condition for last 17 years, she has no place to stay. She is living a nomadic life. She has no source of livelihood. Whatever little source of livelihood they have, they had to leave that. To save their life, to ensure that they are alive, they are just running from one place to another. And it's only the charity of the NGOs who were helping them that they were surviving on. They lost all family members. A womankind is a network, emotional network, which you survive on in a family. She lost every bit of it. Her children doesn't have a family support when you know the women around in the family. And all that because the state could not ensure that no such right take place. If rights have taken place to ensure that she has been rehabilitated, that she has been done justice with immediate effect, that she has been rehabilitated, all these were the aspects which the court really got concerned with and were of the view that we must grant her some compensation of the nature which is not only good enough for her survival, for her rehabilitation, and the state must suffer that compensation. It must come from the coffers of the state.
When it comes to the policemen accused and convicted in it, if you look at the Bombay High Court judgment, no actions were taken on it. But you had demanded for exemplary action on these people. So can you throw some light on that aspect as well?
When we filed the writ petition in 2003, we came against the closure order. There only we have asked for these relief, which was CBI investigation, matter to be then examined properly. The police officials, erring police officials or the government officials, because there were two doctors involved as well, they have to be punished for their inaction, for their role they played. And compensation for all that what she has suffered. Now you have several examples of Supreme Court and the courts where for private or public law remedies, they have granted compensation. Here we wanted to make sure that the police officials are not getting scot-free only by way of a compensation to be paid either under 357 by the police persons or the state. They must be punished for the role they have played because their role was not less than any serious criminal or accused. It was a very, very serious inaction on their part.
So, how do you think that in future, the state government and the central government can ensure that when such things happen, a better understanding of the case can be taken up and the victims can be given proper justice on time, because this should set as an example for other victims as well who have suffered in that mass violence.
See, this to maintain the law and order, to maintain the rule, you have created a body that is police department. They are supposed to maintain that. They are supposed to make sure that you are feeling safe. You are means any citizen of the country is feeling safe. Now that limb can't fail. If that limb fail, where would you go? A citizen is suffering from another citizen, where would we go? We go to the police, we go to the state, we go to the courts. Here that first wing failed badly. So looking to this case where the guilty officials have been have been punished. Not only they have been convicted under the penal laws, disciplinary action has been taken. Their benefits have been taken away by way of the disciplinary action. It should be set an example, and should this judgment should be publicized. Should be a role of media that the state governments are taking that seriously, that they are informing their police officials, and police officials also, they are otherwise supposed to. There would be hardly few who would not be doing their job properly. But for those who don't do, and if they fail, the state government must take proper action. Here in this case, everything failed.
So this would be my last question. How has been your experience being advocate on record for this case, and also when it comes to interaction with Bilkis since 2003?
A painful experience. As a citizen, you would not like to believe that this can happen. I can't even imagine what kind of condition Bilkis must have been through. I don't even know today what kind of faith he has left with the machinery, with the instrumentalities. Can tomorrow, if something is happening wrong to her, would she be thinking of going to a police official, to a police station? Has this judgment brought that kind of protection, that kind of security back to her? I hope this would. But if I put myself in a position, it is impossible to have any time in future for all your life to have any kind of confidence in that machinery which is created for the purpose of protecting the citizens at large, to maintain law and order. So they failed when at the first place the riot took place, when the hooligans or the people were traveling all over shouting on mics that kill the Muslims. And the Muslims, they were vacating the whole Basti. They were running helter-skelter to save themselves. So it is complete erosion of that particular instrumentality which is supposed to protect you. I hope this brings this judgment, the conviction to them, brings that kind of security back to her. And then to the people who have seen through, like what Bilkis has gone through, if they can have that confidence back, that if one fails, there is an entire system there who can bring them back in scene.
Thanks a lot, Shobha, for giving us your time. Congrats and all the best for future struggles. Thank you.